In this video, you will see a super tasty and crunchy Maggi pakoda recipe, which is loaded with cheese and vegetables. This pakoda is covered with cooked Maggi, which makes it absolutely crunchy. Just look at the melted cheese, it tastes fabulous. For all the Maggi lovers, this recipe is a must try. I have shared an important tip to make the pakodas so that your pakodas will never burst in oil while deep frying. So do watch the full video and subscribe to my channel for more such interesting recipes. So let's get started. Here I have taken 2 packets of Maggi along with the taste maker, and in the next step I am going to boil the noodles without adding the taste maker. Here I'm going to boil 1 liter of water, and to that add 1 tablespoon of refined oil and add in the noodles when the water starts boiling. I'm going to cook the noodles from both the packets and use half of the cooked Maggi noodles in the pakodas as well. Take care not to overcook the noodles as they will become very sticky and lumpy. It will be very easy for those who make Maggi regularly to not overcook the noodles and turn off the heat when they are cooked properly. The noodles are cooked and now I will drain the water and keep them aside in a sieve to cool down. To prepare the pakodas, I have boiled 4 potatoes, and in the next step I'm going to grate them. You can mash the potatoes too. Also remember not to overcook the potatoes. They should be cooked completely but not overcooked, otherwise they will be watery and will burst in oil. I will share a very important trick if the potatoes get overboiled by mistake, so keep watching. To the potatoes, I'm going to add some cooked noodles, which will give a good binding. The remaining noodles will be used in the later process. Next, I'm adding in 1 chopped green chili, 1 medium-sized grated carrot, and around 2 tablespoons of coriander, 1 tablespoon of crushed ginger and garlic. And then I will add both the packets of the taste maker. I will not add any extra salt at this stage as the taste maker already has salt in it. With green palm, start mixing till everything is combined well. Now I'm going to share a very important trick here. At this stage, if you feel the potatoes are watery or loose, by mistake they are overboiled and not holding shape, then you need not worry at all. Just take 2 to 3 slices of bread and grind them in the mixer and add to the potatoes. They will soak up all the moisture and then you can make perfect pakodas without bursting in oil. You can use this tip in any other pakoda recipe too. I've added the breadcrumbs and now I will add in some salt. Mix well with greased palms, and in the next step I'm going to roll them in round shapes stuffed with cheese. Take a small portion of the aloo mixture and flatten it as a tikki. In the center, I'm going to add grated mozzarella cheese. Just about a teaspoon is enough, and then roll it into round shape, taking care that there are no cracks left. Otherwise, while frying, the cheese will melt and ooze out in oil. Roll it tightly and keep it aside. I'm going to roll all the pakodas and then coat them with the cooked Maggi noodles. I will roll 1 more pakoda and show you. You can also use processed cheese instead of mozzarella and can even tear cheese slices and add in the center. And here all the pakodas are rolled. These are rolled tightly and make sure there are no cracks in this at this stage. You can make these in whichever shape you like. I have made 1 oblong shape too to show it to you. In the next step, I'm going to make a slurry with maida. To make a slurry, I'm going to take 3 tablespoons of maida, and add some salt to it so that it does not taste bland. And using water, I'm going to make a semi-thick paste, which should not be very thin, otherwise the noodles will not stick onto the pakoras. Also take care there should be no lumps left. Also, instead of 3 spoons of maida, you can use 2 spoons of wheat flour and 1 spoon of maida too to make the slurry. I will show you the correct consistency. The slurry should coat the back of the spoon well and should stay on the spoon and not drip off completely. Then it's perfect for binding the noodles. Dip the aloo cheese ball in the slurry and coat it well. Take some noodles on one palm, put the aloo pakoda on it and cover with noodles and roll between the palms. The extra noodles will fall off. Press tightly and keep aside. I will show you one more time how to coat with the noodles, as in the first clip my hand was a little bit not in focus. And this is done. Coat well with the slurry. Take noodles on one palm. Place the aloo pakoda and coat it with some more noodles. Roll between the palms to give a round shape and for the noodles to stick well too. And it's done. Here all the pakoras are coated with cooked noodles. In many videos, uncooked noodles are stuck on the top coat. After frying, these noodles become too crispy and they prick in the mouth. So do try this method and you will get perfect pakoras. Meanwhile, I've kept oil for heating and in the next step, I'm going to deep fry these. Drop the pakoras in medium hot oil and fry them on medium flame till golden and crispy. I had fried this one in the first batch and just look how golden and crispy it looks. Keep turning them to get golden color on all the sides and it takes about 6 to 7 minutes to fry one batch. These have turned nice and golden. Take them out from the oil and they are ready to serve. I love to eat them with hot and sweet sauce. And here I have fried all of them. They're absolutely crispy and taste delicious. I hope you will make this recipe and not forget to subscribe to my channel for more such yummy recipes. See you soon with a new video. Thank you for watching.